just came back from the dentist last night. Oh, yeah, maybe wondering why I went to the dentist last night instead of just buying the movie off of YouTube. Yeah, for some reason, despite also being on screen service and on YouTube, I just thought...
Why are you hungry
enough? No, I'm not hungry yet. I'm just filming a video here.
Not hungry yet, no?
No, I'm sorry.
Hungry as a...
Okay. Sorry, my horse here. Oh. Sorry, yeah. So... Yeah. We are at the end. Oh, pardon. So... Yeah, I just watched Dune. The reason why I watched Dune was... very simple. Recently, and I just came back from the theaters and thought it was pretty good. Yeah, it was overall a pretty good film, and while the plot itself felt mostly that I'll just give you the general plot. In 10? That was in 10. 109. 1. And House Arrak is this ocean planet that we'll never see again. That you assigned Pendant Emperor Russia. Shema Khan, from the center. To replace House Arrakis and set in our Book of Arrakis. Hello, main setting. Although later on we will known as Dune, also known as Arrakis. Later on, Arrakis. Excuse me. Pretty much a desert planet that you will also see with some unique buildings, and... yeah. And the only thing powerful in this universe is the spice. A valuable substance that extracts human value in critical... oh, for international travel. In reality, sure, it's interesting in House of Rikers. Shadow's just interested in making a cube. Yep, pretty much a cube. Yeah, I really took that coup before. I really took that guy named, like, General Satan. I really took that General Satan. It even killed Cross Drive right for him. Man, I didn't know the problem was named before that happened, but anywho. Sorry, that was almost idea. To the review. Yeah, so they decided. Oh, pretty much just. Anyways. Oh, yeah, right. Spice is also the thing that's basically helped benefits. So, yeah, and a lot of plot lines happen. And. Paul. Atreides, as well as Egypt. Yeah, just decided to move to Duke. For obvious reasons. So. Yeah, I'm not explaining too much of the plot, because aside from maybe a few scenes as well, the past, also the Fortress Stronghold, just the exciting sandworms, and also sometimes, I think somewhere a bit between all the mid and ending of the film, where they kind of just, where I felt it was a little slight on the Snorefest a bit. Felt on the slide of the. Sorry for that. I felt it was getting a little slight on the Snorefest a bit during the mid and ending of the film. I did wake up for a bit of the sort of climax with the knife fighting and the sort of climax and the ending of the. part one, I am sort of a climax because we all know this is going to be a two-part movie. I do enjoy the movie. I think, while I admit, I think the visuals, the designs, the characters, everything does feel book accurate, and even the shields look book accurate. I did feel that, and while I don't really review a lot of the books, I did, though, I think I do remember, yeah, I think these look a lot better than what the 1984 version did, but even though I just do like the joke, like a good laugh of the Minecraft fighting. Anywho. Oh yeah, right, the other things in this movie. I did also do really like what some of the inspiration of Star Wars did. Like the voice, basically Jedi mind tricks. Yeah, I feel like Dune's the voice is more like, I can do j it's basically Jedi mind tricks. Yeah, and considering George Lucas was using it at the time, yeah, technical. I also did. And while I did feel like the Furman foreshadowing was good, and while I did feel like a bit of each stem, and. Yeah, I think it was pretty good. Although I did feel like the movie was a bit on the draggy side. I felt the movie was drag. It's all true. Sad, but at least it was more for book accuracy. Although I did feel like the movie itself just feels like it's drag. Have been, for the most part, dragging throughout the whole. Feels like drag. Mostly, it kind of feels a bit of a drag on the plot. Maybe especially during the more between middle and end, and yeah. The only other complaint I wish they could have mentioned is that, yeah, this is just gonna be part one, and hell, even the title also mentions that this is a part one, mentioned that this is going to be a part one of this movie since the book was a bit long, so they had to cut the book into half the. And yes, I do enjoy the soundtrack and everything. The music is, but so yeah, I think they could have just a little better and say this is gonna be part one before. What they just mentioned, oh hey, we're getting a part two coming out in. In about 2 years' time. Yes, we all know the release date for part two is coming out in like 2 years' time. In 2 years' time. I know we just officially greenlit it and the movie hasn't been fully recorded yet, and I know it's gonna be the second half of the entirety of this. And it's gonna be our second half of the film. So, yeah. Oh yeah, if anyone asked me, so yeah, overall, Dune, at least part one, is pretty good. And it's nice to see the basically inspiration for Star Wars get some recognition, and also Warhammer, and even Game of Thrones got some inspiration for this. Anywho, I'm going to end this review here, and yeah, you may be wondering why I chose to do this review for my chose this review. for to do something like The Eternals or something. Well, I'm not going to say The Eternals was a bad movie or anything, or I'm not thinking about Shang-Chi more. I just thought, why not watch something a little different that isn't a superhero flick for once. And well, aside from anime movies, I feel like I've been watching, for the most part, a lot more superhero flicks and even some individual Star Wars movies, and that's it. Anyway, I also haven't been to the theaters for like a year now, so why not? Eternals, well, I don't really think that's something I'm looking forward to right now, but I'm also going to say, sorry, I kind of got a little detour or anything. Shang-Chi was also because, hey, maybe, but mainly because most of the movies are going to be, moving to Disney Plus. The reason I chose to review the movie pretty much in theaters is, hey, it's been a while, a little since I went to an actual theater. And secondly, I'm not feeling paying additional money just to.
Why am I with the triangle?
Noodles. I felt that if I want, and really, I'm not really interested in paying money to watch the movie on YouTube. And also, I don't know, and HBO Max is not really. Really, I don't. HBO Max isn't in Singapore right now. I don't know if HBO Go has this movie. Me, because hey, oh, it's on HBO Go. Yeah, in Singapore we have HBO Go. So. Oh, we also have it on HBO Go, and it was streaming a little few days afterwards. Seriously, how many times? And mainly because I'm on HBO. It's nice to go into theaters and see. And more on the big screen than me, and yeah. So, yeah, I really felt it was a bit of a slump. But, and yeah, so, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye. So, bye!